And it is very important upon the believers and the Muslims to prepare for Eid al-Fitr. What does Allah want from us on the day and on the night of Al-Eid? The first of them is at-takbir, to declare Allah Azza wa Jal's greatness. And that is by repeatedly saying, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah, Wallahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Walillahi alhamd. Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu, he says that the believers are supposed to be saying this takbir the moment they sight the moon of Shawwal. Number two, it is wajib and an obligation that we pay zakat al-fitr before salat al-eid. And the purpose of this, as the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam teaches us, he says, it is a form of purification for the fasting person. What does that mean? There were sins, there were things that we did we weren't supposed to do. There are things that were wrong that we don't even know about. So our Ramadan is not 100%. How do we perfect it? Give zakat al-fitr, and it'll polish up this Ramadan. It'll rectify those shortcomings. Bi-ithnillahi ta'ala, it becomes perfect. And the second wisdom, as the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam teaches us, tu'matan lil-masakeen, so that it can feed the poor and the needy. The third thing that is supposed to be done, eat something. Eat a date before you pray Salat al-Eid. Why? Because it is haram to fast the day of Eid. It is haram to fast. And when you eat it with an intention of worship. Subhanallah. And then you pray Salat al-Eid. And it is not to be prayed immediately after Salat al-Fajr. Wait until the sun rises by 15 minutes. And when you pray Salat al-Eid, you begin by saying Allahu Akbar. And you repeat that 7 times. Then you read Surah Al-Fatiha and Surah Al-A'la, سَبِّحِ اسْمَ رَبِّكَ الْأَعْلَى. That's the sunnah, otherwise you can read anything else that you know. You complete that rak'ah and then you get up for the second rak'ah by saying Allahu Akbar. Now you've gotten up. Now when you're up, you say Allahu Akbar once again, 5 times this time. You read Surah Al-Fatiha and then Surah Al-Ghashiyah, هَلْ أَتَاكَ حَدِيثُ الْغَاشِيَةِ. That's the sunnah. Otherwise you can read then whatever you've memorized well. And remember, when you're making this takbir 7 times and 5 times, every time you say Allahu Akbar, it wakens the heart. It strengthens our relationship with Allah Azza wa Jal. And it settles the disturbed heart. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. And you repeat it from your heart. Subhanallah, you'll see its effect as you pray Salat al-Eid. And if you missed these takbirat of 7 and 5, then it doesn't matter. Just complete the Salat. And bi-ithnillahi ta'ala, that prayer is a correct prayer. After you finish Salat al-Eid, there is no khutbah necessary to be done at home. And if you did so, then there are also opinions of the ulama that say that this is something that is permissible. Once you finish Salat al-Eid, which is the minimum, you get up and you congratulate one another. That's when you say, Taqabbalallahu minna wa minkum, Eid Mubarak. And you can say any word that refers to congratulating a person on this blessed occasion of Eid al-Fitr. And fear Allah Azza wa Jal for the rest of the day, because this day, Allah Azza wa Jal owns it. You can celebrate, you can enjoy, but do that which pleases Allah Azza wa Jal, and do not violate the laws of Allah Azza wa Jal, whether it's Eid or other than Eid. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept from us all.